What can you do if you have your own cloud server? You can create cloud storage like Google Drive, easily share files, use it as a media server, block ads on the network, do home automation, and many other things. In today's video, we are going to see how to set up a personal cloud at your home without any monthly subscription. We are doing this using CasaOS on Raspberry Pi. So, let's start the video. First, insert the memory card into the computer, which we are going to use to install the operating system. Then open Raspberry Pi Imager. If it is not installed, you can download and install it from the official site. Here, you need to select the device. I am selecting Raspberry Pi 3. Now, select the operating system. We need a lightweight operating system without a desktop environment. Next, select the storage. Now click Next. Here, you need to click on Edit Settings. You have to enter the host name, username, password, Wi-Fi name, and its password. Make sure to note these down somewhere because they will be needed later. Now, save this. And then click Yes here. A warning will appear that all the data on the memory card will be deleted. Click Yes here. Then the operating system will be downloaded and written to the memory card. This will take some time. Don't forget to hit the like button now. When the process is complete, click Continue and eject the memory card. Insert the memory card with Raspberry Pi OS installed into the Raspberry Pi. Then connect power to the micro USB port and turn it on. Now, open the command prompt on a computer on the same network. To connect to Raspberry Pi via SSH, type SSH space username at the rate hostname and press enter. The username and hostname should be what you configured during the Raspberry Pi OS installation. That's why you were asked to note it down. We got a warning. Let me tell you what to do if you get such a warning. Go to the path shown on the screen. Open the file named Known Hosts here in Notepad. There are two entries of Raspberry Pi in this. It came when accessed via SSH before. Delete these and save and close the file. Now try that command again. When this appears, type yes and press enter. Don't just type Y, type yes and then press enter. Enter the password that you gave when configuring Raspberry Pi OS. It won't show even if you type. But type without mistakes and press the enter key. Now we have access to Raspberry Pi. Let's update the packages first. Use the command sudo apt update for that. When the update is complete, upgrade it. You can use the command sudo apt upgrade for that. When it asks here if additional space is required, type Y and press enter to proceed. This is a process that takes a while. If you haven't subscribed to the channel yet, don't forget to subscribe and press the bell button. Because when its subsequent videos come on the channel, you won't miss them. The upgrade is now complete. Now let's install CasaOS. The command for that is this. This will also take some time. So I'm fast forwarding. Now, CasaOS installation is complete. A URL is given here. We can copy this. Open a browser and go to the copied URL. Click on Go here. Create an account by giving your preferred username and password. It asks if you want to show the newsfeed from CasaOS's blog. I'm giving cancel for now. This is the interface of CasaOS. Here you can see system status, CPU usage, temperature, RAM usage, etc. Here we can see the storage information. Only the memory card is shown now. If you connect a pen drive or SSD, that will also come here. If you go into files, you can see the current folder structure. If we add more drives, it will come under the location. Currently, we access this web interface using an IP address. But if this IP changes sometime, we won't be able to access it. But as a solution, we can use Raspberry Pi's host name. If you give that in the address bar and press enter, you will get the web interface. You can access CasaOS using this local address from phones and tablets on the same network. If you go to the account here, there are options to log out and change the username and password. If you go to settings, you can see many options like this. There is an option to search on the web in this. If you want, we can change its search engine here. There is also an option to change the wallpaper here. If you go to the terminal and logs, you can access the Raspberry Pi's terminal. The username and password to be given here are what you gave when you configured Raspberry Pi OS. When you come to the App Store, you can see a lot of apps for a server. It is when you use these that our Raspberry Pi becomes a fully functional home server. Videos about how to use these will be coming to this channel soon. To not miss that, please subscribe to this channel and make sure the bell button is enabled. If you like this video, don't forget to like it. We will meet again soon with the following videos of this.